Hi guys, I'm Anita and I'm back with another video. Today I thought I wanted to do a 2017 survey over everything that I, all of my goals, how I met them and if I met them and what I read and sort of statistics about it and sort of that, and hopefully you'll find this interesting. I always think it's fun to see how everyone ended up doing over the year with their reading progress and if they managed to complete any of the goals that they set for themselves. I definitely haven't completed all of my goals, but I have completed some, but I'll get into more of that later. I'm also planning on having a video up about my 2018 goals the beginning of the new year. But before that, I'm also gonna have a video up with all of the books that I've read since I last did a wrap up. I have 25 books. Hopefully I'll be able to make it pretty brief, yet still get you an idea of how I liked it and if it's something you should pick up. Because I had one video that I filmed with 5 new reviews. I don't know where it is. I might have accidentally deleted it. I'm gonna start over and do a wrap up of everything because I want to start the new year with a clean slate and not have anything sort of hanging from 2017 that I haven't wrapped up when I get to the new year. Obviously, I did a Goodreads main reading challenge this year of how many books you want to read, because I think it's fun to go in and see the statistics of that when you've whatever you've read and who read the same things as you did and all of that. That's the main reason for me to actually participate in those reading challenges. But I don't know. Let's get into my... I also keep statistics of my own in my spreadsheet, which the sort of spreadsheet was actually created by Brock from Let's Read. So I made my own copy of that and sort of added my own books and reads and stuff over the year, and they don't match completely, so I think there's something gone wrong somewhere in the mix. Because on Goodreads it says that I read 108 books, but in my spreadsheet it says 111, so there are 3 books that are not accounted for in my Goodreads totals, and I'm not sure which books it is, but it could be that sometimes I've noticed that it doesn't actually take my start and finish date. So maybe there's a book that I read that I haven't gotten a finish date on, and so because of that, it's not part of the 2017 reads and it's just floating around in the unknown or something. But the total of books that I've read this year was 111 books, and it also says on Goodreads that the pages count is 38,604 pages. But in my spreadsheet, it says 39,798 pages, and that's probably because of those 3 books that it's not completely the same, but it could also be that I couldn't find the right edition on Goodreads, and so I chose another one that has a different page count than the one that I actually have and that I use in my spreadsheet. But this gives an average of 359 pages per book, so that's sort of the normal length, but that makes sense because I read a lot of really chunky fantasy books, but I also read some really, really tiny novellas and stuff. But yeah, the shortest book that I read this year was We Should All Be Feminists by Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie, and that is 52 pages. And the longest book should not be a complete surprise to you if you follow my channel for the whole year, but that is Fool's Fate by Robin Hobb, which is book 3 in the Tony Mann trilogy. And it is 805 pages, and I give that 5 stars if you're curious. It's a really amazing book. The most popular book that I read in 2017 was The Shining, which I just finished yesterday, which has been read by 1,214,571 people. The least popular book, which is something that saddens me a little bit, but I'm not completely surprised about it, is Moroda by L.L. McNeil, and I really enjoyed that book. I think it was a really great start to a new series. She's self-publishing her book, so that's probably one of the reasons why it hasn't gotten a lot of reviews yet and reads yet, but I definitely recommend it, and I have a review of that book in my on my channel, so I'll leave it, that in my card symbol up here so you can go check it out if you're interested in knowing what it's about. It has only been read by 71 people on Goodreads, so... But according to Goodreads, my average rating was 3.9 stars, which is pretty good, and I did have a lot of 5-star reads and 4-star reads, so that makes sense, and a whole lot of lower rated books. But the highest rated book that I read over 2017 on Goodreads was Fullmetal Alchemist Volume 3, which I gave 4 stars. It's a manga and it's a really, really popular one, and there's a lot of ratings on it, but I gave it 4 stars. I still thought it was really good, so I do understand sort of why it's popular. But instead of going over only the Goodreads part, I also have my own from my own statistics, and I'm gonna go into a little more depth about my star rating. So I gave 21 books 5 stars, which is a pretty decent amount. I gave 11 books 4.5 stars, and then I gave 39 books 4 stars. Then I gave 21 books 3.5 stars, and then 11 books 3 stars, 3 books 2.5 stars, and 2 books. Now, 1 book 2 stars. I didn't give out one single 1 star book, but I did DNF. I think 3 or 4 books that I probably would have given 1 or 2 stars if I had completed them, but I don't count them because I didn't finish them. When you look about how the age group of the books that I read are for, I read 65 adult books, 35 young adult books, and 11 middle grade books. So no real kids books this year that I finished. And for the type of book, I definitely have been listening to a lot of audios this year, and I'm not super surprised about it, but that is the largest group, and that also means that the majority of the books that I read this year has been in digital form. It has been like, yeah, I'll put a screen up of it, I didn't write it down, but it's more than half of it that's been digital, but that's because I listened to 47 of my 111 books in audio. And then I read 22 paperbacks, and then 16 ebooks, and the 16 ebooks they add to the digital part. I read 13 hardcovers, 11 graphic novels, and 2 mass market paperbacks. And now looking into sort of my goals that I had set for myself in the beginning of 2017. I wanted to do more book tags on my channel, and I definitely have done a few book tags. But I've also noticed, I think it's fun to film them, but I've also noticed that there's not a lot of people that actually watches them, so I don't feel like it's something that I want to continue, because sometimes I'm doing a book tag if I'm tagged, or if I think it's a funny book tag that makes sense to me. But I just know that not a lot of people actually watches it, so it's sort of not really a good reason enough for me to film it and spend so much time on it, because it does take a lot of time out of your everyday life to film and edit content up. So you want the content that you actually end up posting to be something that people want to watch. And I'm definitely more aware of that. I've been more aware of that over this past year. I also wanted to do quarterly top 5 videos, and I did that. Definitely the first 2 videos. I don't think I did one with the 3rd quarter, and I haven't done one with the 4th quarter because I'm gonna do a wrap up now. I'm not gonna do that because I didn't read a whole lot the past quarter, not enough to actually do a top 5, I think. But I have done a few, and I'll link them in the description box below if you want to check out what my thoughts were about the first 2 quarters. And which books I enjoyed the most. I also wanted to do more book reviews where I focus on one book, and I definitely have done, and I definitely want to have even more in the future. That's something I want to take with me into 2018 as well. And then I also had a chibi art jar, which I don't use any longer. I sort of changed things when I saw that I didn't actually use it. I have instead started doing my TBR unwrappings, which is why my books are wrapped in wrapping paper. And I'll leave a link to the first and second unwrapping in my description box below, so you can watch that. It's it was some pretty fun videos to film. I still haven't gotten to any of the books from the second unwrapping, but it is something that I like, yeah, that I've done instead of the TBR jar. But I did make a new TBR jar with my Kindle books, which is all of them, these tabs, and then I had another jar with books that are from another service that I used, but I have since stopped my account on that because I didn't really read any mini books from there, and I wanted to save. And then maybe once in the future when I feel like I have to want to read them, this series or something of the like, I will restart my account. I felt like that was the best decision for me right now because I didn't read very much. And it is 129 kroners every month for that service. And if I don't read it, it's like, yeah, paying for a book that you don't read. Because one book in Denmark is at least 100 Danish kroners, so yeah. So I decided to stop that, so I have this jar for next year, maybe I'll use it, I don't know, yet. And then I had a goal that I wanted to read 80 books over 2017, and I, as I said previously, I've read 111 books, so I've completed that challenge. So that's definitely good, because I read quite a few books in the beginning of the year, but I didn't read very much by the end of this year. And I also wanted to read one book from my Kindle every month. That didn't happen. I have read 4 books or something from my Kindle, but that's definitely better than nothing, so that's okay. But I still have 300 unread titles on my Kindle, so I definitely had to do something about that. And then I also wanted to read one book from the oldest part of my TBR on Goodreads, but I've decided since then that's a stupid idea, because instead I'm just going through the books. Is it something I'm interested in any longer? And I remove them if I'm not, because my Goodreads TBR is way out of proportions, and I just want to read whatever I want to read and not focus too much on books that I had on my TBR for a really long time, except if I owned them. And that's why I do the TBR thing instead. And then I also said that I wanted to participate in the A Year-a-thon every month, and I've only participated in that in February, so I feel a little bad about that, but that's how it goes. It felt like every month there was another reading challenge that I participated in instead of the A Year-a-thon, not because the A Year-a-thon is a bad readathon, not at all. I think it's really amazing that they do this, and it's really some really fun challenges that they have every month, but it's never really fitted with my reading, and that's why I decided not to participate. And then I also had a goal of finishing one series every month, and that definitely did not happen. I think I've finished 4 or 5 series. I'll put the exact number here when I've looked it up, but I think I'm on 4 or 5 series that I completed this year. And then I have joined a readathon every month. I've definitely participated in at least one readathon every month except December. I haven't been participating in any readathons this month, but all of the other months I have participated in them, sometimes several. So I want to say that this is a successful goal, because it definitely is more than 12 readathons that I've participated in. So this was a sort of survey of what I read over 2017 and my channel goals and all of that. I have had a really good year, I feel like, but I definitely also want to improve some things, and that is what I'm going to talk about in my 2018 goals, and you will see that soon. I think it's going to be up one of the first days of the new year. Before I go, I want to tell you about the books that I've started and have not finished. I don't know why I sort of feel like that, but these books are not books that I've actually DNF'd. They're just books that I haven't completed. So I hope that by the end of next year, I'll have finished reading them for whatever reason. So I'm just gonna go through them now. First up, I am about 100 pages into Roomies by Sarah Starr and Tara Aldobrando. I'm on page 73. I started this in December and I put it down right before Christmas because I didn't really feel like reading this. But I definitely think it's a pretty decent book, so I might pick it up soon. I have started in on The Woman in Cabin 10 by Ruth Ware, which I'm on page 78. So more or less the same amount I've read of this than Rumi's, and it was definitely sort of interesting, but still not holding my attention enough to actually continue it at the time, but I want to finish it, and I still think it was decent enough for me to finish it. I have worked on Into the Wild by Erin Hunter, the first book in the Warrior Cat series. I think it's called Prophecies Begin. I am on page 147. It's sort of just a cat world. And I like them, sort of, but I put it down because I was reading a lot of other books at the time and they were a little more interesting than this one. But I do want to get back to this because I have the whole series. So, and it's not because it's bad at all. I actually think it's a pretty decent book. And then I am about halfway through Crooked Kingdom by Leigh Bardugo. I'm on page 254. And as you can see, it is about halfway. And this is definitely not because I'm not enjoying it. It's just, it's really chunky. And it's definitely interesting when I read it, but then I put it down and then I don't read in it for a while. But I hope that I will find my reading joy soon so that I can finish a bunch of these books. I mean, I am halfway through these books, so it wouldn't take as long to read them, complete them, but whatever. And finally, I have also started on Juliet by Anne Fortier, which is about this girl who finds a letter and sort of mixes up the story about Romeo and Juliet into this. I'm not very far into it, she's just arrived in Italy, and yeah, I think it's something that I enjoy, but it's more of a summery read, so I'll probably not pick it up until the spring, maybe, when things are getting a little lighter outside and I feel like reading it. But my sister has told me that it's a really good book, and my parents both enjoy it as well. Finally, I'm also about 100 pages into The Kriegers by Tom Fletcher, which I hope I'll finish definitely soon. But I haven't really felt like picking it up. But also this one. So those are the 6 books that I am working my way through, that I think I'm gonna finish over the next year. Let me know in the comments down below how you did with your goals this year, and if you complete them. Also, do you have books that you sort of have started and just put on your shelf and then forgotten a little bit about them, even though you actually enjoy them? Definitely also let me know about that. And if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video very soon. Bye!